Volume. A la Shmoop. We're about to go three-dimensional, ladies and gentlemen. You may now put on your special glasses. We assume you've already got area under your belt. Now it's time to add some depth to the mix. We can multiply length times height times depth to find an object's volume, which allows us to determine its capacity. Another way to think of capacity is the amount of space in an object. The amount of objects in space, on the other hand, is a government secret. Let's try a volume calculation. Sorry, we'll pump up the volume up a little bit. 3 times 5 is 15. And 15 times 10 is 150. So this figure has a volume of 150 cubic, whatever you call it.
Oh yeah!
We call these units cubic because you could fit a bunch of cubes in there. Yeah. Eat your heart out, Rubik. When an object contains a large amount of volume, one might reasonably refer to it as voluminous.
Yeah!
Understanding volume and how it works is a necessary aspect of many real-world professions. For example, liquid is always measured in volume, which means that determining how much medicine to give a patient is essentially a volume calculation. Doctors are into specifics, which is why they won't generally tell you to take a bunch of these pills and call them whenever. Volume is also an indispensable aspect of construction, unless you like it when your sewage system explodes. And don't even try cooking something without using volume.
Oh, yeah.
You're in trouble if you're following a recipe that calls for 8 square inches of olive oil.
Wow.
So let volume be your new friend. Accept it. Embrace it.
Ooh.
Just don't squeeze it too hard or you may shatter the measuring cup.
Oh. And whatever you do, never go to 11.
Subscribe to check out more equally fantabulous videos. You should see the subscribe button just below this one. If you're having trouble locating it, we recommend you watch our video, How to Find the Subscribe Button.